Well, hello, and welcome to Short Flix, the program that brings you the best in UCF student films. Today we're sharing four fantastic films: Adam Showen's When the Perfect Comes, an existential journey of self-discovery; Tea Party, a dark story of innocence lost by Matt Fuller; Push to Close, Aaron Mazura's poignant look at motherhood; but first, Diego Kontarovsky's The Last Man, an offbeat look at a bad day at the office. Enjoy!
Wait a minute. Did I wear my business suit today? Or my clown costume?
This is not a sales chart! It's an abortion! Davis! What do you tell your wife when you underperform in bed?
I tell her that I'm extremely stressed from work, and I'll try to do better in the future.
Then I can't wait to hear what you're gonna tell me.
Sure, the chart really looks better if you turn it upside down.
Sit down, Davis. Johnson, tell me about the net usage statistics.
The stats this quarter are surprisingly even, in that they changed a lot, but also not too much, which is exactly what we predicted, as well as the opposite.
I'm sorry, I wasn't even listening. I was blinded with hysterics due to a degenerate display of lateness. I suppose the responsibilities of a real man don't fall on the shoulders of a social animal.
I know, I hate it when people are early. I always try to be early.
Let's continue. You're aware that your psychotic waste of time are costing this company billions of dollars in revenue.
You may have noticed the fact that I've just had sex with Johnson in here. And whether that hurts your feelings or not, I really don't care. Because I wanted to have sex with him, and now I have. And if I never have to hear your opinion about it, my life will be all the more complete. Especially if you're off somewhere else, so I can finally start forgetting about that little imitation relationship that I let you start with me.
You know, I understand what you're saying, and you're 100% right, and you should tell him that. No, you know, in fact, I'm going to go in there with you, and we're going to tell him together because, you know, there's just no way to run a company.
Hey, Davis, we're going out to lunch. You want to come?
Okay.
Everyone take out your reports.
Did everyone sign the card?
Oh, yeah. guy.
Don't write something stupid. What? Why would you write that? What's wrong with you?
What's going on here?
Surprise! Day, huh? That sucks. I got a promotion. Can't wait till tomorrow.
Justin was showing me his ass. I'm sorry. I won't do that anymore. I swear to God.
I thought he was...
I won't do that. Well, last time. I promise.
So unprofessional.
I didn't think Carl would laugh at that. Hit me, baby, one more time.
Show you back to the room, Mrs. Walker, while we get you all checked in.
Would you like help unpacking, Mrs. Walker?
Finish with these.
Okay, great.
Wow.
Lunch is in an hour if you'd like to stay and eat with your mother, and don't worry about her. We're like a big family here. Thank you. Well, if you go up to the second floor, make a right. Your mother's room is on the right. 249. Thank you.
Oh, Mom, it looks like they got you unpacked. You think they could have done a better job at it? Matt and Laurie are flying in a couple of weeks. We can make a trip out to see you in your new place. By then you'll be able to introduce us to some of your new friends.
Are fine. Those don't bother me.
No, Mom.
He did not believe he should ever again love anything, man or woman or his own child, as he had loved the yearling. In the beginning of his sleep, he cried out. It was not his own voice that called. It was Boy's voice. Somewhere beyond the sinkhole, past the magnolia, under the live oaks, a boy and a yearling ran side.
Mr. and Mrs. Farmington, it's so nice of you to join me tonight. One or two lumps of sugar, Mr. Farmington, I can never remember.
I look beautiful in this old dress. Mr. Farmington, you're too kind.
Excuse me, won't you? I can't imagine who'd be stopping in at this time.
Hey, Natalie.
Hello, Nicholas.
Natalie, you're up very late.
Don't you think it's time you got to bed?
but Nicholas, I'm having tea with my friends.
But I'm your daddy, Natalie. Don't you want me to tuck you in? You know, Natalie, you're the best stepdaughter I could ask for. You do love me, don't you, Natalie?
I didn't want to. I know he said that he knows I like it, but I don't like it. I promise, I don't like it. Do you still think I look beautiful?
Thank you.
that brings us to the end of the show. We hope you've enjoyed this episode of Short Flix, the only program that brings you the best in UCF student films. We'll see you next time, right here on Short Flix.